Welcome. In this video, I would like to show you how you can use ChatGPT to translate subtitles. Surely you know that large language models are able to process complex texts and produce quite good translations. However, most of them fail when it comes to translating subtitles. Either they cannot handle the line breaks or the timestamps, or they are simply not good at translating. In contrast, ChatGPT and especially GPT-4 do a very good job. But unfortunately, you can't get the chat window of ChatGPT to generate translated SRT files. If you copy the subtitle text into the chat window, it will stop at every 30th line. If you try to use one of the custom GPTs, this will also fail. Currently, there is a good way to automate subtitle translation. If you use the API connection to ChatGPT. API is the interface through which applications created by programmers can connect to ChatGPT. That's exactly what our little free web app SRT Brain does. You simply upload your subtitle, select the target language and start the translation. It cuts the subtitle into parts, sends it to the API, makes corrections and finally offers the finished subtitle for download. It takes few minutes because the API replies take time. Is it free of charge? Yes, it is. The manufacturer of ChatGPT, OpenAI, offers developers a free credit of $5 for testing purposes. This way you can get API keys with a free credit that is enough for more than 100 subtitle translations. Now we offer you to use our API key for few days. If you are lucky, you can catch this. If this period is over, you can get your own API key easily. Make a new registration on OpenAI website by clicking this link. Use a new email that hasn't been registered on OpenAI website before. Check if you got the $5 credit on the usage page. If you see the $5 credit, you are fine. If you see $0, then you probably used an old email address or you tried to make a new registration from an IP address that is known for OpenAI. Try it again with a new email and new IP address. Generate a new API key that you will use for SRT Brain Subtitle Translator web app. You can do this on the API keys page. It's a good idea to make a new key just for this application. You can make new keys, delete old keys anytime on the OpenAI website. You have to enter a mobile number for SMS validation in order to get a new API key. Please use a number that is new to OpenAI. That's it, you have the new API key. Copy and save it for you. And copy it in the API key field of SRT Brain web app. Then you can go, select input subtitle, select your target language and hit translation. Wait a few minutes and download the translated subtitle. Unfortunately, OpenAI made a few restrictions on numbers of API calls recently. So if you encounter 429 errors, please try to increase the delay between API calls under the advanced options. The default value is 5 seconds. Have fun. If you are interested in the advanced settings, here you go. You can open the advanced settings here. You can select the API model. Basically, you can currently only use the ChatGPT model if you have not yet paid for OpenAI. If you have done so, you can select the GPT-4 model here, which offers a better translation than the normal ChatGPT. Delays between API calls. If you encounter 429 errors, try to increase it. Temperature. This is a parameter for setting the fantasy level of the model. A higher value means more fantasy. In my experience, the model is well trained for subtitles and a change does not bring much. Function types. The function types affects translation quality and token usage. Your credit by OpenAI will be eaten by token usage. If you use the simplest function, translation with timestamps, you can spare the most tokens, but you get a bit poorer translation. That's because the model understands the context better if you feed it with the subtitles without timestamps. Retranslation with timestamps only means that the app only makes one attempt to get a good translation without timestamps. It receives the text back, checks that it matches the original and makes corrections if necessary. If this is not successful, a translation with time stamps is started for this section of text. In full function, the app tries to bring you the best quality and costs the most tokens. There are two attempts for the translation without timestamps, including corrections. If these fail, the translation with timestamps will be used. So that's it, try it out, use it, and we hope the app makes your life easier. If you like it, tell your friends about it.